Take my hand and I will lead the way through all the caverns of my mind.
Hey friends, welcome back to another video, or if it's your first time, my name is Chelsea.
And my name is Nick.
And we're super excited about this particular video because we're going to share a little bit of our long distance story, how we are now a married couple. So for those of you guys who clicked on this video and are like, is there any hope for me in my long distance relationship? There is plenty of hope for you, and we want to show you guys exactly how it worked for us. I know we got a few comments on our last video talking about long distance, which has been a long time, where I surprised him that you guys wanted more long distance videos. So we listened just a few years later. Life is always better. I think the most memorable times that we had together was like surprising one another, where I drove 8 or 9 hours.
I think it was close to nine. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
To go and surprise Nick on his birthday. And that was really fun. I actually missed like almost 2 days of school just to go surprise him.
I still can't believe you did that.
I know. If I wish myself a superpower, I would make this moment last 4 hours. If I had my will, time would just stand still. Wait for me until I find some magic film to take a photograph and live inside.
But looking back on it, it's really special to see the journey that we've been on and where we came from to where we are now and where we're going. And we couldn't have done it without that season. You have to have some kind of financial strategy to make this work. And so when I was working with my parents, I was working on their farm, I was working with their flooring company, I would take a percentage out of my paycheck because I was very serious about our relationship and I knew that I wanted to eventually marry Chelsea, put it into a savings account, and then Chelsea also did the same things. I didn't go to Burger King or Dairy Queen or Starbucks with it. Now I can because we're married. And so when one of us would want to buy a plane ticket, which we were also super cheap on, as long as we could get to each other pretty often, probably about once a month or so for us, I think that was a good amount before we really started getting like agitated.
Which happens because there's only so much time that can go on before you just kind of like desire to like physically touch and see and feel the person that you're with. Just really long to be together so much. A lot of people warned me about a long distance relationship. You're not really getting to know the real person. You are only experiencing like a small tidbit of time. It's always gonna be like La La Land when you're together. That was not the case for us because I also went through a tough time of mental illness and being in the hospital. So I knew that he was like legit and like in it with me, like for me, not for like anything I can do for him or being in a relationship to be in a relationship. So
yeah, that was hard.
It is important to know how someone fights, how they get angry, like all those things are important. And that's what my dad always taught me, is like no matter what type of relationship you're in, long distance, in person, whatever, you gotta know what makes them tick and don't take it to the next phase until you know that sort of stuff, because it's so important. And only that part of the relationship will only heighten as you progress. If you guys are Christians and you're wanting to pursue holiness and God in your relationship, then I found that having a long distance relationship helped with creating those boundaries for yourself and sticking to them, because you're not physically together as much. The first year of our relationship was really great.
But after that, just sucked.
Didn't suck, it was just harder.
It was
like much harder when we were together a lot.
But and some of you guys will resonate to this. Sometimes when you do actually get to be together after those very long stints of being apart, all of that stuff can heighten. So you just have to be a bit careful. I mean, inevitably you want to make up for lost time and you just have to be very, very careful and very wise. One last thing, unless you have other stuff that you want to go through, I think communication, we could talk about that.
Oh yeah, that's huge.
Yeah.
Biggest part, honestly.
Well, I made jokes to it earlier, but Chelsea and I would FaceTime just about every single day,
I think.
I mean, it was rare that we would go a day, especially 2 days, without having, you know, at least an hour or so on FaceTime, just catching up. Hey, how did your day go? Hey, what's going on?
And it's really important too that you kind of touch on the different like love languages that the person resonates with, because sometimes you can't physically be there, but you can send something that can physically be there. Or sometimes you can't physically be there to watch a show together, but you can watch the 100 on Netflix and watch a show together.
Yeah.
That's what we did several times.
And then brag on me here for a second. What did I do for you really often?
Which I would love if he did again. He would send me flowers just randomly in the mail.
Aww.
And he just like got in contact with like our local like florist and sent them to my door, and I like never expected it. It was always like random occasions. It wasn't like my birthday or Valentine's Day. He did that on those occasions too, but it will just be so fun to do that together, to like surprise one another in some sort of way. Even
yes.
if you can't physically be there, like sending
yes.
flowers, sending whatever. Sometimes if you just send $5 square cash saying, hey, I got your coffee for today, like,
yeah.
love you. Like, just little things like that.
Anything that you can really do to show them that you're giving them attention, or something that affects their daily life. So whether that's sending $5, sending them flowers, something that they can touch and feel tangibly, that shows your affection and shows your care for them. I think that stuff matters way more than it's given credit for, because if you just stay distant and there's never anything in the relationship to where something becomes tangible, or you can touch and feel something that someone gave you that cares about you,
yeah.
then you just begin losing that emotional flair. So if you can do any of those things, $5 gift card, $10 gift card, send
yeah.
some flowers, or if so. You're wanting to send something to the guy,
it's just showing that you care.
Yeah, just anything showing that you care, you have affection for them.
One last thing I want to say. So I think this is like 0.5, 6, whatever.
Five.
The biggest thing in terms of like goals of your relationship is making sure that you have an end period in mind, an end goal for the relationship to become in person, because the goal of a long distance relationship isn't to stay long distance. Some people are weird about that. I want to stay in a long distance relationship for the rest of their life because they just like having like a pen pal or whatever.
God bless.
That's fine. But I'm speaking to those who want to get married, who want to like be in the presence of one another.
To the 99%.
And I thought you were going to high five me.
No. Oh, wait.
That was awkward.
Wait. To the 99% of you who want your long distance relationship to end, this is how to do it. This is the culminating moment where everything comes together, because when
yeah.
there is a light at the end of the tunnel, it's really easy to hold on to hope, hold on to faith. We can get through this. Let's keep grinding. Let's keep hustling.
Let's
keep putting money away so that we can see each other. But ultimately, you do want to have that time and moment where you sit down and you decide, hey, these are my goals for the relationship. I'm convinced that I want to get married in the future. And that's a really big thing. It's a weird conversation to start, but I think if you begin the relationship correctly, it'll just be kind of a natural path. Yeah, I mean, there needs to be some kind of light at the end of the tunnel, because it's really hard to keep going when you don't have that.
And that doesn't mean when you first get in a relationship, or like your first few weeks or months into it, that you need to be like,
yeah.
oh my gosh, I'm moving to Pittsburgh, whatever it is. Like, I think just knowing from the moment of being like, this is a person I want to be with, this is the person I want to invest my time in, I just think the person you end up spending your life with is worth investing in, and is worth like setting that goal for, and just really strategically working towards it. So
yes.
that is one thing I wanted to harp on, and we hope you appreciated it and that you will want more like this in the future.
And so just some encouragement to you, the season that you're in is necessary. It's yeah. for a reason, and you absolutely can get through it, because we did it, we know people who have done it, and it is possible. So don't lose hope, don't lose faith.
Yes, exactly.
Until you came along, you took
and that's where we'll end because I know you guys don't want to hear us talk forever. But we're just really thankful we got to share a little bit of our story and some tips for you guys. So let us know if any of it was helpful. We appreciate y'all. Thank you so much for tuning into the video, and we will see you on our podcast and in our next video.
Later.
Bye, guys.